San Marino is going to Eurovision 2021 with Adrenalina by returnee Senhit, featuring, well, a bit of a megastar. But will they get our hearts racing, or will we flatline? Let's review Eurovision. So Adrenalina is the song that San Marino are sending to this year's Eurovision. They've taken part since 2008, then they had a bit of a break. They came last in that 2008 contest, had a break of a few years, and then returned in 2011. But if you don't mind, I will be here. With Senhit, and she's now back in 2021. She was supposed to be there in 2020. She's now back this year. And she's not the only San Marinese artist to have multiple attempts at Eurovision. Look at Valentina Minetta, for instance, the dame of Eurovision. She has been to Eurovision 4 times to represent San Marino. She made the final once in 2014. Even though her best entry ever is quite widely assumed to be Crisalide from 2013. And then the more kitsch Eurovision fans will be a fan of the social media song. Yep, that happened in 2012. And then skip forward and we've had multiple entries from Senhit. That was an interesting couple of entries from him. But Senhit is back in 2021 to represent San Marino. It is a tiny, tiny country. There's only about 34,000 people that live there. Only ever been in the final twice. So normally they do struggle to get through, but will it happen this time? They've enlisted Senhit again with Adrenalina, and somehow, they've managed to get Flo Rida to feature on this one. We'll talk about it in a second. Here is a snippet of Adrenalina. So that was Adrenalina, but what do we think of it? Emily, we'll head to you first.
So yeah, I'm a big fan of this one. I think San Marino's entry last year kind of gave us a feel of something that they had maybe kind of more potential at Eurovision, because obviously their past couple of years have not been particularly successful. But Adrenalina is kind of so upbeat and exciting, and the fact that they have Flo Rida featuring on it, and the fact that he seems to actually want to come to Eurovision, I think makes it kind of a really exciting entry this time around. And I think San Marino's kind of qualifying rate for the final has been kind of pretty dire, and I think this should be, you know, surefire straight through to the final. So yeah, I'm a big fan of this one.
So we had very positive words there from Emily. James, are you as enthusiastic about San Marino's entry?
Well, yeah, San Marino's a name, and I think winning could be the game with this one, I've got to be honest. I really, really like it. In fact, I absolutely love it. You know, I really, really like this one. I mean, you know, it's got a bit of that sort of Katy Perry feel about it, I think. Which I love. I think it's very catchy. It's got a good tune. I mean, literally, as soon as it's been released, I've had it on constant loop on my phone. It's like, I think probably already one of the top played ones on my Spotify account. I love it so much. I think, you know, I could easily see this playing in a club or something. You know, if I wanted a night out, I'd be well and truly on the dance floor, you know, dancing along to it. I think, you know, it's, to me, it is pure Eurovision and pure pop, which, you know, I love. And I'm sure we all do watching this too. And so, yeah, I think it's a really, really good piece. I can't sing its praises enough, really. I absolutely love it. And I think it could do quite well.
So also very enthusiastic responses there from James. I think it's brilliant. Absolutely, absolutely brilliant. And I have been watching, I've been an avid follower of Eurovision since 2011. So when Senhit entered for the first time. And since then, there's been, I mean, about around 500 entries that have been on the Eurovision stage, roughly about 500. And I know all of them pretty well because I followed it like a nut. And never, ever, ever have I been as shocked as I was when I first heard this. Because San Marino has got a pretty not great record. The songs are really kitsch normally. They're really naff. So for them to come along with this is just, like, my brain has only just managed to compute how good it is because they never send anything like this. It's never normally this good. So it just fills me with pure joy every time I listen to it. It makes me smile. It makes my shoulders bop. That it is just pure, unadulterated joy. And the amazing thing about it is that Flo, I mean, the fact that they managed to get Flo Rida, like, what the heck? That is, like, it's, again, a testament to how good the song is, that Flo Rida isn't even what makes this amazing. Like, it's still, if he wasn't in there, I would love it just as much as I do now. So that just goes to show how amazing Senhit is on it, how amazing the song is. I have nothing, absolutely nothing negative to say about this. It is a stonkingly amazing entry. And yeah, absolutely love it. So San Marino is performing first in the second semi-final. They're opening it. Often that can be a little bit of a hit and miss sort of position. It's a big ask going first, but will San Marino make it through of the second semi? Emily, what do you think?
I think there's absolutely no reason why it shouldn't go straight through. I think especially if they do end up with a Flo Rida there, I think he'll definitely kind of carry the kind of San Marino brand, give it kind of a bit more than it currently kind of has. Yeah, I think it should go straight through to the final. I think for me personally, it's my number four. So I've ranked it, yeah, pretty, it's definitely up there. I think it's the first time San Marino was kind of really registered on my kind of Eurovision radar. So I'm excited. I think it has the potential for kind of staging that we've kind of seen quite a few times before, but it's a tried and tested method. So there's no reason why it shouldn't qualify essentially.
So number four there from Emily. James, how's it done with you in your ranking? And do you think it'll qualify?
So then, in terms of my placing of it, I think, as I said, this is going to do really well. I think it will stand very strong in the final, so much so that I've actually put it as my number two, which is very, very deserving, I think. I absolutely love it. I mean, I really nearly put it as my number one. I've got to be honest. It was only because I think at the last minute I couldn't really decide between my number one and two, and I ended up having to put this on second. But I mean, the more I listen to it, the more I actually love it. So I don't know, maybe it should have been my number one, but nevertheless, it is in at my number two spot.
So fourth, second, here we go. It is my number one for the year. I think it is just perfect. And I don't use the P word often at all with entries at Eurovision. There's a very, very limited list of songs I think are perfect, and this is one of them. I think if it doesn't qualify, I genuinely will never watch Eurovision again, because if this kind of quality isn't recognised just because it's from San Marino or just because it opens the semi-final, there's no point really. And the opening semi-final isn't the end of the world, because Norway in 2018, That's How You Write a Song, that opened the semi and ended up winning it. So it's not a complete drawback. San Marino cancelled qualify, and they absolutely deserve to. I also am scared quite a lot of making Fuego comparisons here. And as you've seen the Israel video, the Azerbaijan video, all of those, whenever a comparison to Fuego has been made, I've sort of shut it down quite quickly, because Fuego is so brilliant and it's so up there that you can't even compare. This isn't as good as Fuego, but this is by some distance the most excited I've been about a Eurovision entry since then. I think I cannot wait to see how it's going to look. And I want them. It's my personal, I said in the French review, do I do my ranking based on my head or my heart? My head says France is going to win. My heart wants this to win, because I am so shook by how amazing it is. The shock of it. Only love for this entry. So that's what we think. Overall, when we add all of our scores together, that gives San Marino a score of 7, which is easily the lowest we've had yet. It is, clearly our number one so far. There's still, of course, a lot of entries left to review, so that could change. But San Marino now leads the way in the Reviurovision ranking for the 2021 entries. But thank you very much for watching. If you like what you've seen, if you agree, disagree, like, comment, subscribe. And if you do subscribe, make sure to hit the bell notification to get notified every time we upload new content. But thank you very much for watching and see you next time.